got a table of data here, but I want to convert the rows to columns. Luckily, this is easy with SQL. It's time to do the pivot. I'm watching my figure, so I'm tracking how much I eat. For everything I consume, I'm writing down what it was, the date and time, and how many calories. This gives a big list of what I've eaten, but it can be hard to see if I'm staying within my daily calorie limits. To overcome this, we can group by day and sum up the calories. This is better, but if I regularly overeat on Saturday, this can be tricky to spot, particularly if I'm on one of those diets that allows me to eat more at the weekends. To help with this, what we really want is a table with weeks down the side and days across the top. This makes it easier to see if there's any days where I just can't resist stuffing my face. Luckily, this is easy with SQL. First, there's a couple of things we need. The day of the week, which you can extract from a date using toChar, and the first day of each week, which you can get with trunk. We want one row per week, so group by the first day of the week to do this. Then we need 7 calorie counts, one for each day. But if you just add them up, you get the weekly total for each day. To fix this, inside each sum, check if the current day is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and so on as appropriate. If it is, return the calories for that day, and null otherwise. So now we've converted our daily rows to weekly columns, but the SQL is kind of messy. And in the sums, we have 7 similar, but not quite the same expressions, making mistakes likely. Luckily, this got a whole lot easier with the pivot clause. To use this, start the query again, sticking pivot after the from clause. In here, you need to state 3 things. Firstly, the values you want to go in the new columns. Pivoting normally combines many rows into one, so this must be an aggregate function. Here, it's the sum of the calories. Next, you define the pivoting column, which is the toChar of the date, and last, a list of all the values from that which become columns in your results. Here, that's the days of the week. But do this and you're going to run into a problem. You can't use a function as the pivoting column, only a real column. But we don't have day of week in the table. To overcome this, you need a subquery that does the conversion, then pivots the results of that. As we also want the start of the week, we can put that in here too. But now we've got another problem. The output has one row for each week and food. That's not really what we wanted. We just wanted one row for each week. So why that? Well, Oracle Database adds an implicit group by to your pivot. Any columns in your table or subquery that aren't in the pivot become part of this grouping. We've selected food, but not included in the pivot, so it becomes a column in the results. To fix this, remove the unwanted columns from the subquery, or you could add them to the pivot. For example, we could also have columns showing a list of all the things I've eaten each day. ListAgg is a handy function that does this, combining the rows into one comma-separated string. Do this and it's clear. I'm eating too much at the weekend, but am I loading up on nice healthy fruit? Or stuffing my fat face with cake? To help figure this out, it'd be useful to have the daily calorie total for each food. To do this, we could write out all the foods in the in list. But this list is likely to be large and change slightly from week to week. You could list out the foods I eat regularly, but this could miss last night's late night nacho binge. Really, you want this in list to be dynamic, so the columns change based on the data selected. If this was a where clause, you could do this using a subquery. Sadly, this doesn't work with pivot. You've got to explicitly list out the values. Unless that is, you're brave enough to play with XML. By doing an XML pivot, you get your results in this format. And you can replace the in list with a subquery, or use the any keyword, which dynamically generates the values. This seems easy, but instead of separate columns for each value, you just get one. This contains an XML document. Each value is in its own item tag, so if you want them to become columns, you still need to know what the values are and get good at XML manipulation. So this can be a problem if you want the column list to be dynamic. There are other ways to overcome this problem too, but each comes with their own drawbacks. In general, if you want the column list to change regularly for your pivot, you probably need to rethink your requirements. For now, let's just list out some of the common foods. But if that's all we do, we get the totals for every day. We only wanted to see this for Saturday, so we need a where clause. Pivot sits between the from and where clauses, so if you want to filter the results, place this at the end. Or you could restrict the rows to Saturdays in the subquery. This is a good idea, as it ensures you access as few rows as possible as soon as possible. Filtering early like this is a great principle to follow in SQL, because the smaller your dataset is, the faster your queries are likely to be. Do this and it's clear, I'm eating too much cake. But am I having small snacks throughout the day or one monster cake orgy? If we started with this table with foods as columns, we could convert them back into rows. It's time to do the unpivot. To do this, replace pivot with unpivot. Again, you need three things. First, a column to store the calorie totals for each food. Next, so we know which food these values came from, another which will show the source column name. Finally, list out the names of the columns which will become rows. Here, that's the foods. So now we have a table with rows for each date and food. But the source table didn't have the time I ate things, so we don't know if I've got small snacks throughout the day or I'm eating all my cake in one go. This is a general problem with unpivot. If the table you're unpivoting contains aggregated values, there's no general way to de-aggregate them. This can be a problem if you start with a table and then pivot it and then unpivot it again. As we've seen, pivoting is a powerful operation for converting rows to column totals for days, weeks, or months. But it has many other applications too, such as converting sporting results to league tables. Unpivoting has fewer applications, but it's still useful to have in your SQL toolkit. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this and want to watch more SQL videos, click the links on screen now.